Okay, so good morning all. The experiment that we'll be doing today is strain measurement using a strain gauge. Okay, so this is the instrument that we'll be using to measure strain. So first of all, we have to calibrate this instrument such that it gives the correct reading. So here we are having a strain gauge. Okay, this is the load that we'll apply. Okay, each cylinder is of 100 gram weight. And the total weight is 1 kg. So we will take this thing here and we will apply the weight to this cantilever beam. Okay, and we are going to calculate the strain of this cantilever beam using our instrument. Okay, so this beam is actually connected to our instrument here. As you can see the circuit of the instrument, the strain gauge is connected as a Wheatstone's bridge. Okay, and any change in its length will cause a change in the resistance that will bring this Wheatstone's bridge into an unbalanced condition. So that voltage is actually amplified using an instrumentation amplifier. Okay, so this is the physical parameter that we need to measure, that is the strain. That strain is sensed using the strain gauge and it's converted into an electrical signal using a Wheatstone's bridge configuration. That voltage is amplified using an instrumentation amplifier, and finally the output voltage is displayed in your meter. Okay, so this is the instrument that is being used to measure our strain. Okay, so now let us see how to calibrate this instrument. Okay, so first of all we'll remove this load, we'll keep it aside. So this is our strain gauge as it is. So we have applied zero load. Since we have applied zero load, the output should be actually zero, but it is displaying as minus 2. So what we'll do, we'll change the zero balance here. Okay, this is the zero balance calibration system and this is the final value calibration system. So for zero balance, we'll rotate this potentiometer such that the display will show zero voltage. Okay, now our display actually shows zero strain. Okay, since we have applied no weight, we have applied zero strain. Okay, now let us put the final weight, that is 1 kilogram weight, to this strain gauge here. And corresponding to 1 kilogram weight, actually the strain is calculated to be 377 micro strain. Okay, the calculation is shown here. The strain of this device is calculated using this equation, 6PL divided by BT squared by E. Okay, and the final value when we apply a weight of 1 kilogram is 377 micro. Okay, 377 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay, so that much change in length is coming when we apply a 1 kilogram of weight to this strain gauge. Okay, so if 1 kilogram has been applied, our output should display 377. So using my final calibration, I will make this value as 377. Okay, 377 is the final value. Now I'll remove this complete load and see whether actually zero is coming or not. If zero is not coming, then I have to again calibrate this using this zero setting. So I'll again calibrate this to become zero, and again I'm applying this complete weight here. So you have to do the calibration till you get the correct value for both sides. Okay, so here we are having 377. Okay, 376, 377. It is fluctuating. That will be not a big problem. Okay, so if we are having the final value as 377, let us see Again, what happens when we remove this load? Okay, now it's zero. Okay, now we can say that our strain gauge is correctly calibrated. 376, just we'll make it 377. Okay, 378, that will be enough. And if I remove the load, zero. If I put the load, it is 376. Okay, 376, 377. Okay, that's a minor change only. So we can say that our device is correctly calibrated. Now to perform our experiment, we will apply 100 gram, okay, of weight each time to this strain gauge, and we'll see what is the measurement for each of the value, each of the weight, okay, and we will compare it with the actual value. Actual value means the value that is that we get from using that equation, okay. Okay, now I have removed all the 100 gram units. Now I am going to apply. Okay, this rod is a 100 gram first of all. Okay, so for 100 gram actually the output should be 37. Okay, this is the actual reading that I need to get, that is 38, 75, 113, etc. Since I am getting 43, that means my calibration is not correct. Okay, no, actually the position was wrong. Okay, I'm getting 36. Okay, instead of 38 I'm getting 36. So a minor error is there. That is the beauty of calibration. So by calibrating you can actually minimize this error. So now I'm putting another 100 grams. For another 100 grams the output that I'm getting is 73, and the actual reading is actually 75. So this is because of that minor error we had in during the calibration. Okay, 74 instead of 75 I'm getting 74 strain. That one value difference is because instead of 377 we had done 378. I'm adding another 100 grams. I'm getting a value of 112. I am adding another 100 grams. I am getting 151. I am adding another 100 grams. I am getting 187.